good evening and thank you for joining me tonight on Hotspot. On our lineup, we catch up with some of the young guns of the PNG Touch team. The Pukpuks took time out of their training schedule for a bit of community service here in Port Moresby, and the revival of Team Fly and Tarama Diggers in this year's Capital Rugby Union Sevens Challenge. But first, the resignation of FIFA President Aepp Blatter and the Pacific Games to be used as a qualifier for the 2016 Olympics.
I have said I forgive, but I don't forget when it comes to persons and to not to facts. And I have said also yesterday, I have been elected by 133 national associations, but I am the president of everybody, and I'm also the president.
The announcement, while not unexpected, still came as a shock to many football pundits, considering the statement was made only 4 days after his re-election as FIFA president. Observers around the world expressing varying degrees of satisfaction.
If he's stepping down, he's done the right thing. He probably shouldn't have even been voted back in as president to start with. I think it's about time that everyone's woken up to what he's been doing for the last 12 years with everything. I think it's probably the right thing that happens, yeah.
If he goes, I think a bunch of top flight FIFA members will go. And I think that cleans it up from the top as opposed to from the middle levels we'd expected to go from. He's definitely gone.
English FA chairman Greg Dyke said he was delighted with the resignation and called for fundamental changes within football's governing body.
FIFA needs massive reform. First of all, it needs financial reform and a financial accountability, which it's never had. It needs someone to go in there and find out how much is coming in, how much is going out, and where it's being spent in great detail. Once you've done that, you need to sort out the governance of the whole sport, which is all over the place. I mean, it's...
He also expressed reservations into the timing of Blatter's announcement.
Well, the question is, why didn't he do it before the vote last week? And then clearly something has happened between Friday. I mean, when I left the Congress on Friday night and was interviewed by ITN, I told him, look, this isn't the end of it.
Blatter, who had ruled FIFA since 1998, was left reeling this week after the announcement of top officials within the organization being arrested and investigated over fraudulent payments made prior to bids for both the 2018 and 2022 World Cups to be hosted in Russia and Qatar, respectively. Domenico Scala, head of FIFA's Independent Audit and Compliance Committee, said there would be 4 months' notice for any new presidential election. In the men's event, 8 teams have been confirmed to take part. 5 of them, IOC member associations, Fiji, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Solomon Islands and Vanuatu. 3 more non-IOC member associations will also be competing in the Pacific Games branch of the competition: New Caledonia, Tahiti, and the Federated States of Micronesia. The 8 countries will be drawn into 2 groups of 4 teams, with the top 2 IOC members from each group set to progress to the semifinals, and the winner set to contest the final, where the victor will go on to represent the OFC at the 2016 Olympic Games in Rio, Brazil. The format to find the winners of the gold, silver and bronze medals for the Pacific Games will use the same group competition as the OFC Olympic qualifier, but it will be the top 2 Pacific Games Association members from each group who will then qualify for the semifinals. 2015 Pacific Games Women's Football Tournament will double as stage 1 of the OFC Women's Olympic qualifier, with 7 teams set to participate. IOC member associations Cook Islands, Fiji, Papua New Guinea, Samoa, Solomon Islands and Tonga are all taking part, with the only non-IOC member association participating, that of New Caledonia. In this event, a group of 4 teams and another of 3 teams will play a round robin on a league basis. The winner and runner-up of each group qualifying for the semifinals, and the winner contesting the Pacific Games gold medal. The highest-ranked IOC member association will qualify for Stage 2, where a home-and-away playoff against New Zealand in October awaits them. The winner of the playoff on aggregate score will represent the OFC at the Women's Football Tournament in Rio next year. The draw for the OFC Men and Women's Olympic Qualifying Tournament has yet to be announced.
We head out for a short break. Stay with us with more on Hotspot. If you've just joined us, you're watching Hotspot. Let's join Lorraine and the Pukpuks taking time out to do a bit of community service.
Yeah, boy. The Mediterranean alarm, boy. Them know what's coming, boy.
The general.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, boy. The Mediterranean alarm, boy.
Thanks, Colin. Now I'm here at the Puma Energy service station at Konedobu with assistant coach Douglas Geist. Now, what are the boys doing at that moment?
The boys is, you know, sponsored by Puma Energy, so we're just helping out with the community involvement and general Pacific game awareness for the public. Eh?
Now, how important do you think it is that the boys get involved in the community down to that level to drive the awareness for the Pacific game?
It's very important that we all have the boys know where they fit in society and help out where they can, especially in the community. And with Puma sponsoring, we've got to give back them some support as well, because they've supported us a whole lot this past year.
Now, can we expect to see the boys doing more of these community engagement activities?
Yes, they are. They have been. We've been involved with our school programs, with the PNG Rugby Junior Development. Also, we've been doing awareness around the country with around the city with Puma. And next week, we're heading off to the Aroma Sevens to help out with a junior school program out there alongside the Aroma Coastline Sevens. So, got a bit of a lot of involvement with the community by the Sevens boys.
Now, just very briefly, do you feel that the boys do have a big enough following for the games?
At the moment, yeah, we have a bit of a following. As you know, Sevens is a pretty it's a world sport compared to a few other sports involved in the Pacific Games. So, we're trying to give a lot of coverage for the Sevens because, as you know, the Australian team is also coming for the Sevens, as well as Fiji is sending their number one team. So it'll be a good tournament, yep.
Now, you mentioned Fiji sending their number one team. How do you think the Pukpuks will go against them? They are the world champions.
I think we're quietly confident that we'd do well in the games. Against Fiji, well, like I said, we're not results-based at the moment. We just want to stick to what we've done over the past couple of months in our training and processes. The last time we played Fiji was in the New Caledonia games, it ended up in a 19-all draw with Fiji coming out in extra time. So we're going to take confidence from that and see how it goes this game.
Well, Dougie, thank you very much for your time. Now, we the whole MTV sports team actually would like to wish the Pukpuks all the very best of luck. Hopefully you guys don't lose to the 15s boys anymore leading into the Pacific game.
Thanks for having us, and I'd like to just give a special mention to Puma Energy for helping us out and letting us come and helping them today.
And thank you, Lorraine. Still on rugby, the CRU Sevens Challenge sees the emergence of Team Fly and the Tarama Diggers this season.
Yeah, after 31 years, all the guards, all the back, fly low, play low, Sevens in here. Fly, team, also all young youths all interest to play. So, also people around nothing, staff nothing, big one play. Big man, interest also because we play around nothing and put the team fly go inside. The people enjoy the game, so we take part. We get inside the community, we get take part play. Okay, I like talk soil or community where also most stop nothing almost also may encourage them all play sports. Sports is a good thing for youth to play. So thank you, Mcha.
Yeah, we started off in round one and we won our first game and we lost our second game. But we're really happy with our performance during the week. Our training was really good. To be honest, we started training 6 weeks before the first match. And most of the boys, they didn't play in Union, they play in other sports like AFL
We have Tarama Sons in Tarama, and we also have other leagues team in Tarama also. So, yeah. Some boys play in both sports. Some weekends they go and play in other teams. That's it. At the moment, we don't have in a women's team, but we are working on that.
Will you guys be putting a team for the 15s competition when it starts?
Yeah, yeah. We're gonna put it. Starting, I don't know when the 15s commence. Yeah, I think. Right now, we didn't. There isn't any. There's a temporary management team in place, so we haven't a stable team yet. So when the management are organized, so they'll tell us our sponsors then.
We head out for another break. Stay with us as we catch up with some of the young guns of the PNG Touch team. Welcome back to Hotspot. We now take a look at some of the young guns of the PNG Touch team.
Teams are numbers here. Pack him numbers.
Name me Nadia Taubuso, me play local Brave Touch.
This is the first time do you selection go inside the women's team?
Yes, I'm the first time coming to the team.
Your selection go inside the women's team has brought you to the World Cup and now we play the Pacific Games. What was the experience like playing at the World Cup overseas?
Okay, the World Cup, first time do me lo travel too, but first time me been panic, and then second game me get a use lo play and me confident. First game me play the World Cup and me panic click, and then second game also me use na me got confident lo me at na me go and na me play.
And first time you travel.
Yes, and first time me to la travel.
And now we play the Pacific Games, so say me lo home soil. Ba got some pa impressa na ba to?
Yeah, ba me play want impressa ya. Yeah. Me pili awa mas I'm looking forward to play lo Pacific Game. Lo team all. I'm all senior players. So me at the same new plus, so me consider as me junior. Na melody sila team. So me as me sign up the wing position. Lo me at the me finish a melody sila game. All play inside, but wing I'm me probably finishing sila game. Finish?
No, yet.
Oh.
I can see the look on all their face. I'm moving to the left, moving to the right.
Especially my dad, supporting me and motivating me. Look, I'm a good player.
Named me Jacqueline. Me 19, but by me December 20 or December, the middle of East Britain. Me play okay. Lo play one to look. See some like an experience. Lo about na come here. Yeah, first time me lo play lo
up.
I'm alright, mix it good lo experience lo team or give me na me play. True lo also na me play come assembly yeah. Play lo PNG game na come get out lo selection. I'll get out of the World Cup. Yeah.
This will be your first PNG.
Yeah, game, my first.
Pacific Games, sorry.
Yeah, they're my first time.
You've
really
been born time
1991. Oh, my God. yeah, just wish them all happy and love go all.
They'll be watching.
Yeah.
okay, what name do you play in the association?
My name is Paul Mata, so I'm playing with Istigak Association at Keweng. So I'm here to...
Let me ask you.
Yeah, sorry.
That's okay. Is this your first time to be selected into the PNG Touch team?
Yeah, that's my first time, so we have been going on to World Cup and now it's the second time to play it. Pacific game.
What's the experience? What was the experience like playing at the World Cup overseas?
Played the World Cup. I've got many experience down there, so I come here. I'm trying my best to be open and play with other friends here to gain more experience.
The competition level overseas is it different to what it is played here at home?
Yeah, the competition down there is very high, so. Our boys too, we did well, and yeah, nothing.
That's fine. I'm a first time really play the Pacific Games on home soil. How do you feel about that?
I'm feeling good, so this time, that's my first time to be playing with Pacific Games. And back at the home here, plenty team. So, last season we played and plenty team for Kevin. So, me one blood, but Kevin actually bring me come on top. So, me selected, but can play low. So, I represent province we played now. So, now I'm young. Me try my best to low. Compete to boys low. But must be yet. So, this was test low. It's a 2 weeks this way. I'm black am the test. So, I'm bring challenge to me. So, I must try my best to beat him all.
You got something to talk to online, lo please?
Nothing much to say, but thanks for your support there. MJ, thank you.
And we wish the PNG Touch team the best in their preparations for the Pacific Games. We head out for our final break. Stay with us as we wrap up the show with our weekend draws. Come to the end of the show. Make sure to tune in on Monday night at 9 p.m. to catch all your sports results with Jeremy and Dion on Sportscene. And join Lorraine for all your Pacific Games update on Road to Port Moresby 2015. Now let's take a look at what's coming up this weekend on our weekend draws. Off our weekend draws, and in round 13 of the Intra Super Cup at the Colourbond Oval this Sunday at 2:30 p.m. the SPPNG Hunters will take on the Ipswich Jets. And moving over to the Intercity Cup ladder, in the Northwest Pool, Simbu Lions lead the pool at 11 points, followed by Mandy Murugs on 10, Hello Wigman on 8, Hagen Eagles on 5, Wagitumbe and Engamioks on 4. In the Eastern Pool, Lace Necks, Tigers and Rabaul Gurriers lock horns at 12 points, followed by Gorokola Hanis at 8, Galfi Sapeyas on 6 and Port Moresby Vipers on 4. Coming up this Sunday in Round 8, in Port Moresby at 12:30pm at the Murray Barracks Oval, Galfi Sapeyas will go up against Gorokola Hanis, followed by Port Moresby Vipers taking on Rabaul Gurriers at 3pm. Mandy Moroks will see Simbu Lions in Mandy, followed by Hagen Eagles meeting the Engameoks in Mount Hagen, and in Minch at 2pm, Wagitumbe will take on Hella Wigmen. Moving on to AFL in the Easy Loan AFL Premiership this weekend at the University of Papua New Guinea Ovals this Saturday at 9am. In the Women's Division, Garahu Magpies will take on Oilmead Gordon's Kokopas, followed by Lamana Dockers taking on University Tigers. And in the Senior Men's Division at 3:30pm, University Tigers will go up against Garahu Magpies. On Sunday at 9am in the Men's Reserve Grade, Concept Coveney will meet West Giants. And at 4pm in the Senior Men's Division, Moni Plus Tarama Sons will take on Oilmead Gordon's Kokopas. Reminder that if you'd like us to feature you on Hotspot or have us train with you on our special segment Get Involved, please shoot us an email at sports@emtv.com.pg. I know most of you are on Facebook, so please check us out. And if you're in Port Moresby, drop by to Second Floor Garden City and ask for our awesome sports team, and we'll be more than happy to assist you. But until next time, play hard, play safe, and we'll catch you right here on Hotspot.
Shake, shake, now drop. Boom, boom, shake, shake, now drop.